Hi, I'm the paint diva of New Jersey. Today we're going to be going into a Cape Cod style home that was built around 1950. And we're going to go into the basement, into the rec room, and we're going to do a low budget renovation. We're going to paint an accent wall, we're going to do some stenciling, we're going to paint an old secondhand piece of furniture, and we're going to turn this room into a groovy hangout for teenagers.
Fun and feeling groovy.
We're gonna roll with the retro. We're gonna turn this into a groovy hangout, all on a low budget, all done with paint. We're gonna break this up into a short series of how-to videos that you can watch on YouTube, and you can watch from beginning to end. So come on along with me and watch me renovate this room, and we'll go from an old home into some divalicious days. Hi, I'm Cindy, I'm the Paint Diva. Today we're gonna talk about what to do with all of those old unused sample jars and unused quarts and containers of paint that you have laying around the house. We're going to do an art project today. We're working on a contemporary room with a 1960s retro feel, and we're going to create a painting on this canvas. Now, you can do a couple of things. You can go to the craft store and you can buy a pre-stretched canvas like this, but a large one this size is probably going to run you about $100. What I'm doing today is I'm repurposing an old canvas that I had. I actually used regular wall paint. I primed it and I painted over it in a gloss paint just because I wanted this to have a slick, shiny surface. Another option would be to go to a garage sale or yard sale and find yourself an old painting, an old canvas for maybe 10 bucks and do the same thing. Just prime it, paint right over it. I don't want a frame on this because we're going for a contemporary look. If this had a frame, you could either pop the frame off or you could tape off the frame so that you don't make a mess on your frame. What we're going to work to today is this contemporary looking design. All I did was I Googled 1960s retro wall art. You can actually buy stickers or stencils if you want, but today I'm going to actually draw this on and use all of my unused paint. Pretty basic design, squares and circles. Pretty much anybody should be able to do this. And remember, it's art, it doesn't have to be perfect. Don't get too picky about it, don't try to make it perfect. Nobody's gonna know the difference. It's all about getting color onto the canvas. I've got some craft brushes that I bought at the craft store, very inexpensive, and we're going to just open up the cans and use the paint. Since all these are water-based paints, all you need to do in between colors is dip it in the water, clean up your brush, and wipe it off with a rag.
Time.
sections. You do want to do a second coat. If you're doing a project like this, you can still see the brush strokes. I want a nice solid finish, so I'm going to do the second coat. Make sure when you switch colors that the other colors dry. So I'm waiting for this blue to dry before I go back in there and fill inside with the new color in there. This orange is already dry, so that's a nice way to get nice clean edges. I'm cleaning up my edges here with my second coat after the orange is dry.
You got to make the morning last, just kicking down the cobblestones, looking for fun and feeling groovy.
Pretty much do it. So there's our piece of artwork. Using up all our leftover paint colors, our retro 1960s piece of art. Anybody can do it. Like I said, just don't try to be a perfectionist. It's all about just getting color on a canvas and just have fun with it. This is Cindy's Paint Diva. Hoping you have a Divalicious day.